Welcome everyone to the 2020 graduation ceremony of the Department of Integrative Physiology. My name is Mark Opp, and it is my privilege to serve as chair of the department. I would like to begin by acknowledging all the hard work by those who organized and prepared this virtual ceremony, particularly Marcia Cook for leading the entire process, Brian Gordon for putting together all the video presentations, and Brandon Michielli for gathering and organizing all the slides from our graduating seniors. I also would like to acknowledge the rest of our IPHY staff who worked so hard this year to support you, our graduating seniors. Hannah Bethke, Trisha Ward Brooks, Eric Helpney, Angie Jimenez, and Paula Yamashita. For many of us, the science of physiology is a mystery. To help demystify what your sons and daughters have been studying for the past 4 years, we now show you a short movie about the Department of Integrative Physiology.
How does the nervous system learn new movements? How do genes influence behaviors that impact our health? How do lifestyle and aging influence the heart and blood vessels? How can we optimize the performance of elite athletes? How does the nervous system modulate sex hormones and influence reproductive function? How does stress affect the immune system and our health? How do sleep problems affect our health and well-being? These are some of the questions that attract students and motivate faculty in the Department of Integrative Physiology at CU Boulder. Physiologists study organisms as functioning systems of molecules, cells, tissues, and organs. Our goal is to link observations on the individual systems to the function and behavior of the whole human body in health and disease. This interest in whole body function makes us unique among the life sciences programs here at CU. Over 30 faculty members direct research programs that contribute new knowledge about the physiological functions they study. The research laboratories also provide rich learning experiences for our undergraduate and graduate students, who are often included as co-authors on the 100 research publications written by the faculty each year. Several faculty members also have joint appointments in affiliated programs, including the Institute for Behavioral Genetics, the Center for Neuroscience on the CU Boulder campus, and clinical divisions at the CU Anschutz Medical Campus and at the Veterans Affairs Eastern Colorado Healthcare System. The Department of Integrative Physiology is the largest major in the College of Arts and Sciences. Majors take a sequence of lecture and laboratory courses that include anatomy and physiology, biomechanics, cell physiology, endocrinology, exercise physiology, immunology, neurophysiology, nutrition, physiological genetics, scientific writing, sleep physiology, and statistics. They also serve as teaching assistants in undergraduate courses, acquire research experiences in faculty laboratories, and earn academic credit for professional internships in off-campus clinical settings. Undergraduate majors completing the BA in Integrative Physiology enter a number of health-related professions as doctors, nurses, physical therapists, physician's assistants, occupational therapists, dentists, and pharmacists. They share their physiological knowledge with their patients and clients. At the graduate level, IPHY offers Master of Science and PhD degrees. Most master's students develop a program of study that includes research training in faculty-directed laboratories in the department, whereas others complete the degree with coursework only. Approximately half the master's students use the degree to improve the probability of being admitted to a professional program. Most of the others enter a PhD program where they must demonstrate competence in research by completing a dissertation. Approximately half of the graduates from our doctoral program become the next generation of researchers in academia, and the others pursue opportunities in industry. Students and faculty depend on staff members who manage the day-to-day operations of the department. The staff coordinates academic programs, advises undergraduate students, oversees finances, human resources, and information technology, and supervises departmental property in 8 locations on the Boulder campus. Within the organizational body beats the heart of IPHY's core missions, answering important real-world questions of human biology, training students to keep asking questions and seeking answers, and sharing those answers with people who need them to lead healthy lives. This is Integrative Physiology at CU Boulder.
I hope everyone appreciated the movie and you now have a much better understanding of our department. Why should IPHY graduates of 2020 be looking forward? Obtaining an undergraduate degree is one of the biggest achievements in anyone's life. Your degree in integrative physiology opens doors not available just a few generations ago. As IPHY graduates, you are prepared to make meaningful contributions to health professions that encompass nursing, physical therapy, dentistry, medicine, and others. Serving in these professions benefits society, and as evidenced by current events, the need is great. This graduation ceremony marks the close of one chapter and the beginning of the next. There will be many chapters in the book of your lives, each one distinct and different from the previous. Chapters in your lives will encompass relationships, jobs, and careers with transitions that are anticipated and planned, and those that are not. At some point, you will realize that your life and career have not been defined by events that transpired during your last semester at CU. Rather, the events of this semester will be just one of many experiences that will shape your lives. Thank you. It is now our privilege as faculty to honor a group of students whose excellence extends outside the classroom. IPHY is known for its exceptional students who go beyond normal expectations and take advantage of the many opportunities for research and scholarly activities. One achievement of which CU Boulder students may be very proud is graduating with Latin honors. At many institutions, graduating with Latin honors requires sustained academic performance and maintaining a high GPA. To graduate with Latin honors from CU Boulder, an individual must maintain a minimum GPA of 3.3, but also conduct a research project, write a thesis, give an oral presentation of the research, and successfully defend that research. As such, graduating with Latin honors at CU Boulder is recognition not only of excellence in academic performance, but also in research or scholarly work. We will now acknowledge these IPHY graduates for their sustained efforts in completing an honors thesis and graduating with Latin honors.
Graduating with Latin honors, summa cum laude, awarded to Chang Lu.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Professor Bob Mazzeo, IPHY Associate Chair of Graduate Affairs, who at this time will oversee the presentation of our graduate degrees.
Hello, everyone. My name is Bob Mazzeo. As the Director of Graduate Studies for the Department of Integrative Physiology, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the master's candidates who will be awarded their degrees with us today. These young scientists have spent the past years at the University of Colorado working diligently to collect, analyze, and prepare their findings for publication in the appropriate scientific journals. In addition to these responsibilities, these students are required to take 30 hours of coursework, as well as serve as teaching assistants for the many undergraduate courses offered by our department. So let's begin.
Larissa Hunt. Hello, my name is Ruth Heisler, and I'm a senior instructor and the Associate Chair of Undergraduate Affairs in the Department of Integrative Physiology. I want to start by congratulating all of our graduates for your persistence in making it to this momentous day. Even in a normal year, this would be an impressive milestone, but you have shown incredible grit and determination through your senior year to make it to this day. How many of you knew what Zoom was 2 years ago? I didn't. How many of you had heard of breakout rooms? I hadn't. And how many of you thought pets would become a common sight during class? Certainly not me. But you adapted. We all adapted. And it is this ability to adapt, overcome, and complete such an impressive goal that defines you. You are all so deserving of having your moment in the spotlight to celebrate this great accomplishment. I want to start by recognizing the recipient of the highest GPA award. Although we are not allowed to list individual GPAs, I can assure you that this is an impressive accomplishment.
The highest GPA award goes to Maxim Kondratinko.
I am honored to introduce our student speaker for this graduation, someone many of you may be familiar with, Larissa Hunt. Larissa is a Boulder native who has completed both her bachelor's and now her master's degree in integrative physiology. During her time at CU, Larissa graduated from her undergraduate summa cum laude, completing her honors thesis in Dr. Celine Vetter's lab studying light and sleep. Continuing her work as a graduate student in Dr. Vetter's lab, she is focused on circadian and sleep epidemiology, which combined her interest in data science, sleep, and nutrition. Her master's research project was recently published in a special edition of the journal Nutrients. As a graduate student, she has been a teaching assistant for both the anatomy labs and the endocrinology course, and we are really going to miss her enthusiasm for teaching. Her immediate future plans are to do some camping and hiking with her dog, and then pursue some research opportunities in the sleep and nutrition epidemiology fields.
Parents, friends, dignified guests, faculty, and class of 2020. I am so honored to be the student speaker at this year's Integrative Physiology graduation ceremony. Today, I would like to share a personal story and then talk a little bit about the whole experience that we've had this year. When I was 12 years old, my mother took me and my 14-year-old sister and moved us all to Antigua, Guatemala. We enrolled in an all-Spanish school and spent a year learning the language, enjoying the culture, and finding ways to keep ourselves out of trouble. For a long time, I had thought of this as perhaps the most jarring event that a 12-year-old could have experienced. I was taken away from everything I knew and could comprehend, and was shoved into a world where I didn't even speak the language, much less fit in. As a 12-year-old, this experience was both a foray into a rich and wonderfully interesting world, but also a terrifying departure from everything I considered normal. But now, as a 24-year-old graduate of a master's program, I look at all the fear that I felt at that time of my life, and I couldn't be happier for it. The fear of the unknown is both shared by all and personal to everyone. But it is that very fear that drives us to grow and motivates us to succeed. We stand here as graduates because we are willing to wade through the unknown and plunge into worlds that we didn't understand, both in math and physics, and perhaps the more terrifying world of college-age human social structures. The lesson here is that embracing that fear makes you better for it. And if you embrace it at every opportunity, you will succeed where others don't. This year, we have gone through perhaps the most jarring and difficult year of schooling that any undergraduates have had to go through in recent memory. with the online courses, the shifting schedules, the obscene difficulty of not having Starbucks open to study in, and that pesky little thing called a global pandemic. It has been a heck of a ride. I'm sure that many of you thought that you might not get through it, that you might not graduate, or that you might have to stay another semester to make up some English credit because they didn't offer it. But you made it. If you can use 2020 to teach you anything, it should be that uncomfortable times breed uncommon people. We have the option to look at our senior year in college as wasted and difficult, or we have the opportunity to look at it as the thing that will most motivate and propel us forward for the rest of what I hope is a long and happy life. When we think back on our college experience, we'll think about how we had to write mundane papers, spend hours working on a single line of code, or sit in a dark corner for hours memorizing anatomical terms for little bones that we'll literally never have to think about again. But we can also remember the wonderful professors and friends we met along the way, the lasting knowledge that we've spent all those hours encoding that will undoubtedly help us on Jeopardy in the future, and the way that we've developed into the uncommon, in a good way, humans that are graduating today. We are not the same people that we were when we entered CU Boulder. Nor are we the same people who entered the year 2020. But I, for one, believe that we are better for it. All the credit cannot go to ourselves, however, we must share that with our support systems, to our families who supported us every step of the way, the loving and caring IPHY faculty and staff who dedicate themselves to allowing students like ourselves to grow and learn, the wonderful CU facility staff who make the environment one that is clean and suitable for learning, and all the other people involved with this wonderful university. I think I speak for all the graduates when I say, thank you. We could not have done it without each and every one of you. One last thing before I let you all go celebrate. As you look into the future, many of you will see a future that is hazy, or you might not quite be sure of what to make of it. I am here to tell you that if you continue working hard, and if you embrace being uncomfortable whenever you can, you will get to where you want to be. Don't be afraid because the journey isn't quite clear and you don't know what step to take next. Be excited that you get the opportunity to find it. Congratulations, class of 2020.
We have finally reached the moment you have all been waiting for, the recognition of each of our graduates. As you watch the next portion of the ceremony, please remember this. Each of you are the heart of IPHY. Your accomplishments are our accomplishments. Whether you already have the next 5 years planned out or are still figuring out what to do next, remember the skills you have developed here. You have learned so much more than just anatomy and physiology. You have learned grit and how to face challenges head on. You have developed scientific thinking and communication skills. You have learned how to use statistics to interpret data and explain that data. You have learned how to budget your time and work with others to complete a common task. But most importantly, you have learned that you are capable of finishing something you started, something really big. And you should all be proud of that accomplishment. Now, the more than ever, we need individuals like you going out to make a difference. So please stay in touch with IPHY. We want to continue to be a part of your big accomplishments. With that, I congratulate each of you.
Daniela Adamczyk. Adelia Behrens. Julie Ann Bennett. Dominic Paul Bonsignore. McKenna Bridgman. Ermina Mawuna Clark. Ifana Seconde Clark. Shane Cohen. Luke Desmond. Justin Michael Downing. Avery Maitland Dwyer. Megan Rose Harley Eberlein. Alexandra Taylor Eddy. Jinji Guo. Ellie Lynn Himyak. Brenna Linus Hurst. Ajmita Idate. Douglas Elliot Kerber. Sarah Jane Kester. Colleen Marie Klein. Maxim Andre Kondratinko. Alyssa Noelle Kaiser. Rana Lauer. Caitlin Ashley Lau. Zeeman Lepore. Alexandria Elizabeth Lewis. Menji Liang. Xiao Liang. Chang Lu. Brennan Michael Lyle. Raina Majesh. Cassandra Marquez. Hannah Mashner. Sydney Lucille Maddox. Eileen Grace McConnell. Nicholas Ray McDaniel. Bailey, Marie McLagan. Brandon Heath Middlemist. Declan Thomas Moyer. Jacob Alex Noring. Gabriel Ross Oliver. Lucy Kahia Apencario. Shazni Nicole Osterhoos. Atham Upali. Isabella May Patterson. Catherine Diane Phillips. John Christian Prom. Richard Frederick Holes. Madison Riley Ryacom. Nick M. Rodriguez. Veronica Rodriguez Ramirez. Tyler Ryan Romero. Nicholas Roscoe. Kazol Safi. Charlo Sandstrom. Catherine A. Schaefer. Michaela Seaman. Abigail Jane Tubman. Max Liam Understein. Claire Ann Veldkamp. Victoria Michelle Watanabe. Madison Taylor Wilson. Mina Wong. Maxwell Allen Zapp.
Hello, IPHY 2020 graduates. Heidi Bustamante here, coming in virtually. I want to wish you all a huge congratulations on your graduation. Although I don't get to personally shake your hand and give you a hug to give you those congratulations, I am virtually able to do that. I want you guys to know that although we cannot meet, it does not take away from all of your accomplishments and your hard work. At the end of the day, you're still going to get your University of Colorado diploma. You're still going to be an IPHY graduate, and you will be a forever buff. I want you guys to know that as you head into your future endeavors, you can count on me for anything that you may need moving forward. Please reach out to me and please keep in touch. Again, congratulations on all of your accomplishments and for making it to this day. I wish you all the very best in your futures, and again, know that you can count on me if there's anything you need. I am very, very proud of all of you, and I wish you all the very best. Please take care of yourselves, stay safe, and take care of each other. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hi, class of 2020. You have worked so hard and now have mastered the concept of negative feedback, at least in endocrinology. So what are you going to do next? Hopefully, celebrate really hard and enjoy the rest of this really special day. Congratulations to you all.
Hi, class of 2020. This is Dr. Foley. I just wanted to congratulate you for finishing your IPHY degree. Such a huge accomplishment. I'm sorry we couldn't do this in person, but please come back and visit. We would all love to see you.
Well, this is Dr. Link here from his home studio, and I'd like to wish all the IPHY graduates big congratulations. You succeeded with situation with extra levels of difficulty. So you deserve a big shout out. In particular, I'd like to give my congratulations to the graduates of my cell physiology class. I hope your worm pickers never break. All your expectations go as you would like. So again, congratulations and best of luck in your future careers.
Hello, graduates. Dr. Staub here. I wish that I was able to deliver this message to you in person, but I want to congratulate each and every one of you on your huge accomplishment of graduating from CU as an IPHY major. You've come a long way in the last several years, and it's been a journey with a bit of an unexpected ending, but I know that you will go on to do great things as you move on from CU. Take care of yourselves, and I hope that we cross paths again in the future.
Congratulations, IPHY graduates.
Hello, I'm Dr. Tammy Maldonado. Integrative Physiology graduating class of 2020, congratulations. That you have reached this milestone is no accident. You know that college is hard work. It requires integrity, tenacity, sacrifices, and a belief in your career goals. I'm sure that there were times when it felt like a long and arduous road. And now, with that part of the journey behind you, I hope that you can reflect back on your educational career at CU with joy and that you're proud of your accomplishments. We certainly are proud of you. So do go out and celebrate your accomplishments with family and friends, and then take a deep breath, because there will be a day when this outbreak subsides and you have a new story to write. So as soon as you can, go out and do something wonderful. Congratulations to you and your family.
Hello, graduates. Congratulations. You've made it to the end of the semester. Good luck.
Hi, everyone. This is Dr. Janet Cassegrand of the Department of Integrative Physiology, wishing all of our graduates congratulations on this very special day, and also to your family and friends who are celebrating this happy day with you. Congratulations and best wishes.